Hi students, have a nice day. In this section we are going to discuss about Dalton's partial pressure, kinetic theory of gases and some numerical problems. First of all we discuss about the Dalton's law of partial pressure. As we know that John Dalton is proposed atomic theory in 1808. And he was known as father of atomic theory, modern atomic theory. In 1801, John Dalton proposed a law is called Dalton's law of partial pressure. When non-reacting gases is taken in a vessel or in a cylinder, the total pressure of the mixture of gas is equal to sum of the partial pressures of individual gases. Once again, in a mixture, the total pressure is equal to sum of the partial pressures of individual gases. Okay, let's take a cylinder. Or a vessel with a volume V. Volume is constant and temperature T volume and temperature must be constant. I fill oxygen in this vessel, oxygen O2. Also argon or nitrogen. The gas must be non-reacting, that is very important thing. Okay. So what is the total pressure? The total pressure P total is equal to partial pressure of O2 plus partial pressure of argon. If you take oxygen and nitrogen, P total is equal to partial pressure of oxygen plus partial pressure of nitrogen. Are you clear? Yes. So, according to Dalton's law of partial pressure, in a mixture containing non-reacting gases, that's very important. In a mixture containing non-reacting gases, the total pressure of the mixture is equal to sum of the partial pressures of gases, all gases present in the cylinder or vessel. Okay, let's generalize. If the cylinder contains many gases, P total is equal to partial pressure of first gas plus partial pressure of second gas plus partial pressure of third gas, etc. We generalize Dalton's law. P total is equal to sum of the partial pressures of gases. Then what is partial pressure? In a mixture, the pressure exerted by the individual gas is called a partial pressure. Okay. In a mixture, the pressure exerted by the individual gas is called a partial pressure. Here, oxygen and the argon is filled in a cylinder. The volume is constant. The temperature is constant. So the pressure exerted by the oxygen is called the partial pressure of oxygen. And the pressure exerted by the argon is called the partial pressure of argon. A very simple concept. Okay, so hope you understand Dalton's law of partial pressure. Next we move to, generally we collect the gases over water. Okay, for example, nitrogen is collected over water, non-reacting gases, okay, collected over the water. So when the gas collected over water, the gases were moist. Okay, the gas contains water vapor also, because water is vaporizes. So in that mixture, water vapor as well as the dry gas is there. Then what is the pressure of this dry gas? What is the pressure of the dry gas? P total is equal to, okay, first I write the total pressure. P total is equal to P of dry gas plus pressure of water, partial pressure of water. Because when we collect gas on water, okay, this is water, the gas is collected in water. Here the, for example, let's take nitrogen. So here the nitrogen gas as well as water vapor, because the water is vaporizes in that chamber or in that tube. So total pressure of this mixture is, total pressure is equal to dry gas, that is pressure of nitrogen, I write here, partial pressure of nitrogen plus pressure of water. And the vapor pressure, the pressure of water in the vapor phase when it is saturated is called aqueous tension. Another thing, aqueous tension. Okay, what is aqueous tension? The partial pressure of saturated water vapor. Okay, the partial pressure of saturated vapor pressure is called aqueous tension. That aqueous tension for different temperature is given in the textbook. So it depends upon the temperature. So for calculation, for when we are doing the problems, the aqueous tension is provided at different temperatures. Okay, then what is the pressure of the gas, dry gas? The pressure of dry gas is equal to, the pressure of dry gas is equal to total pressure, P total minus aqueous tension. Okay, so two important concepts. P total is equal to pressure of dry gas. I here take nitrogen, pressure of dry gas plus aqueous tension, and the pressure of dry gas is equal to total pressure minus aqueous tension. Okay, so it is sometime useful for the calculations. So next we move to the partial pressure in terms of mole fractions. Partial pressure in terms of mole fraction. Okay, I erase this. According to Dalton's law, P total is equal to sum of the partial pressures of individual gases in the mixture. Then next is partial pressure and mole fraction. Partial pressure in terms of mole fraction. Okay, we know that mole fraction is the ratio of number of moles of one component to the total number of moles of component present in the mixture. Chi I is equal to, or chi 1 is equal to N1 divided by N1 plus N2 plus N3 etc. Or chi I is equal to Ni divided by sigma Ni. In the first chapter we study this one. Also, according to ideal gas equation, PV is equal to nRT. Okay, in the last section we discussed about the ideal gas equation. PV is equal to nRT. Then, what is pressure P? Pressure P is equal to nRT divided by V. nRT divided by V. And remember that in the case of partial pressure, Dalton's law of partial pressure, volume and temperature constant. All gases is taken in a vessel. So volume must be constant and the temperature also constant.
So what about P1? P1 is equal to N1 R T divided by V. Okay. Then what is P2? P2 is equal to N2 R T divided by V. What about P3? P3 is equal to N3 R T divided by V. Are you clear? Then P total is equal to partial pressure of sum of the partial pressure of individual gases. P total is equal to P1 plus P2 plus P3. This is according to the Dalton's law. Then it is P1, P2, P3 substituted by this thing. Okay. R and T, R T divided by V is common. So let's write a N1. Okay, I complete the sentence. R T divided by V plus N2 R T divided by V plus N3 R T divided by V. Okay, R T divided by V is common. So N1 plus N2 plus N3 into RT divided by V. Okay. RT divided by V. So that is P total. Then let's divide, let's take P1 divided by P total. P1 divided by P total. I write here. P1 divided by P total is equal to N1 RT divided by N1 plus N2 plus N3 RT divided by V. Okay, P1 is equal to N1 RT divided by V. We substituted. Then P total is equal to N1 plus N2 plus N3 RT divided by V. Okay. So RT divided by V is common. So PI divided by P total is equal to N1 divided by N1 plus N2 plus N3. What is this? PI divided by P total is equal to P1. PI is the general equation. P1 divided by P total is equal to N1 divided by N1 plus N2 plus N3. What is N1 divided by N1 plus N2 plus N3? It is mole fraction Chi1. So we generalize. PI. Similarly, we can prove that P2 divided by P total is equal to Chi2. P3 divided by P total is equal to Chi3. Okay. So, PI, generalization. PI divided by P total is equal to Chi I, mole fraction of the components. This is general equation. From that, we can easily identify the partial pressure. Okay, I just erase these things. Another important conclusion. From this equation, partial pressure of gas is equal to, first I write the equation. Pi is equal to chi I into P total. Okay, Pi is equal to chi I into P total. Generally, we can write that partial pressure of gas is equal to mole fraction of gas, mole fraction into P total. It's a very important equation. Partial pressure of gas is equal to mole fraction into P total. Okay. So this is the relationship between, or this is the
equation partial pressure in terms of mole fraction. Okay, a very simple derivation. Now you need for vary this. PV is equal to nRT, you can take. So P is equal to nRT divided by V. P1 is equal to N1 RT by V. P, similarly, P2 N2 RT by V, P3. Then apply Dalton's law. For, according to Dalton's law, P total is equal to P1 plus P2 plus P3. Just apply, rearrange, and P1, okay, P1 divided by P total, we get P1 divided by P total is equal to chi 1. Similarly, P2 divided by P total is equal to chi 2, P3 divided by P total is equal to chi 3. Generally, we can write that Pi divided by P total is equal to chi I. From that, we can easily found that Pi is equal to chi I into P total. That is, mole fraction of the gas into P total. Okay, if we know the mole fraction of gas, we can easily determine the partial pressure of the gas in that mixture. Let's discuss some numerical problems based on the Dalton's law of partial pressure. The first question. The total pressure of sample of H2 is collected over water is 730 mm Hg at 29 degrees Celsius. The aqueous tension at 29 degrees Celsius is 30 mm Hg. What is the pressure exerted by the dry H2 gas? Once again, I read the question. The total pressure of a sample of H2 is collected over water is 730 mm Hg at 29 degrees Celsius. The aqueous tension at 29 degrees Celsius is 30 mm Hg. What is the pressure exerted by dry H2 gas? Okay, the data given is P total. P total is equal to 730 millimeters of mercury. Okay. And the aqueous tension, because the hydrogen gas is collected over water, aqueous tension is equal to 30 mm Hg. The temperature given is constant. The total pressure is measured in 29 degrees Celsius, as well as the aqueous tension also taken at 29 degrees Celsius. Okay, so temperature there is no need for in the problem. And we know that P total is equal to P of dry gas plus aqueous tension. AQ tension means aqueous tension. Okay, shortly written aqueous tension. Then what is the pressure of dry gas? We have to calculate pressure of dry H2 gas. So pressure of dry H2 gas is equal to P total minus aqueous tension. Okay, the dry gas is equal to total minus aqueous tension. A very simple problem. P total is 730 mm Hg minus 30 aqueous tension 30 mm Hg. And what is the pressure of dry gas? It is 700 mm Hg. Okay, so what is the pressure of the dry H2 gas? It is 700 mm Hg. A very simple problem. Then the second question. A mixture of gases at 760 mm Hg pressure contains 65% nitrogen, 15% oxygen, and 20% carbon dioxide. Okay, so in the mixture there is 3 gases. What is the partial pressure of each gas? Once again, I read the question. A mixture of gases at 760 mmHg pressure contains 65% nitrogen. So nitrogen percentage N2 is equal to 65% and 15% O2. Percentage of O2 is equal to 15%. And carbon dioxide is equal to 20%. What is the partial pressure? So partial pressure Pi is equal to mole fraction into total pressure. Mole fraction into P total or total pressure. Here the percentage is given. Okay, so what is the mole fraction of nitrogen? So pressure of nitrogen is equal to, very simple problem. Pressure of nitrogen is equal to mole fraction. What is not mole fraction? The number of moles of components per total number of moles of components. So percentage means 65/100. 65 number of moles per 100 moles of mixture. Into what is the total pressure? Total pressure is equal to 760. P total is given 760 mmHg. Okay, 760 mmHg. So multiply 760. It is equal to 760 mm. That is equal to 494 mmHg. Then what about the pressure of O2? It is 15%. So mole fraction is 15/100. Total is 100. Into 760 mmHg, that is 114 mmHg. And what about the pressure of CO2? Partial pressure of CO2 is equal to 20/100. Into 760. Total pressure of the mixture is 760. Then it is equal to 152 millimeters of mercury. A very simple problem. The percentage of gas is given. Percentage means out of 100, 65 nitrogen, 15 oxygen, 20 carbon dioxide. Okay, so here the concept is partial pressure PI or partial pressure of any gas is equal to mole fraction into P total of that mixture. Okay, the next problem is taken from the NCERT book. Okay, 5-4. I read the question. A neon dioxygen mixture contains 70.6 gram dioxygen and 167.5 gram neon. If pressure of the mixture of gases in the cylinder is 25 barometer, what is the partial pressure of O2 and neon in the mixture? Okay, once again I read the question. It is taken from the NCERT book, solved a problem 5-4. A neon dioxygen mixture contains 70.6 gram of dioxygen and 167.5 gram of neon. If pressure of the mixture of gases in the cylinder is 25 barometer, what is the partial pressure of O2 and neon in the mixture? Okay, let's collect the data. First is weight of oxygen is given, or mass of oxygen, weight of dioxygen is given. It is 70.6 gram. And weight of neon is given. Weight of neon is equal to 167.5 gram. Okay. And if the pressure of the mixture, that means total pressure, P total is equal to 25 bar. And the question is, what is the partial pressure? Partial pressure P1 and P2 is the question mark. Because two gases in the mixture, oxygen and neon is in the mixture, that's why two gases in the mixture, P1 and P2 is the question mark.
Is there any relation? Mass and total pressure?
We know that mole fraction and partial pressure is related. Mole fraction, total pressure and partial pressure is related. The mass is given to determine the mole fraction. How we determine the mole fraction? First of all, we determine the number of moles of each gases. From that, we can easily find out the mole fraction. Okay? Yes.
First of all, we determine the number of moles of O2 is equal to,
how we calculate the number of moles? Mass divided by molar mass,
70.6 gram divided by 32 gram per mole. It is 2.21 mole.
Okay, I write it here because the other part is used to calculate the partial pressure. It is 2.21 mole.
Similarly, number of moles of neon is equal to, number of moles of neon is equal to 167.5 gram divided by, what is the molar mass of neon? It is 20. Okay, 20 gram per mole. It is equal to 8.375 mole. Okay, what is mole fraction of oxygen? Mole fraction of O2 is equal to number of moles of chi. 1 is equal to N1 divided by N1 plus N2. Here, 1 is this. So, 2.21 divided by 2.21 plus 8.375 is equal to 2.21 divided by 10.585. Okay, 585. It is equal to 0.21. The mole fraction of oxygen is equal to 0.21. And what about the mole fraction of neon? It's very simple. 1 minus chi 1, that is 1 minus 0.21 is 0.79. Or you can calculate by numericals. It's a time consuming. How the mole fraction of neon is calculated? It is calculated by 8.375 divided by total number 10.585. You get the same answer. Okay, no need for doing like that. Only two gases, two components in the mixture. So this mole fraction of second component is 1 minus the first component. Okay, then mole fraction of both components is obtained. So what is Pi? Pi is equal to chi I into P total. Then what about partial pressure of oxygen? Partial pressure of oxygen is mole fraction of oxygen 0.21 into total. P total is equal to 25 barometer. So by multiplying these two, we get 5.25 bar. Okay. 5.25 bar. Yes. Then partial pressure of neon is equal to, how we calculate the partial pressure of neon? It is mole fraction of neon. Okay, general equation is this. Partial pressure of neon is equal to mole fraction of neon into total pressure. Mole fraction of neon is this one. So partial pressure of neon is equal to 0.79 into 25 barometer. What about it is 90.75 barometer. Why? Total pressure must be 25 barometer. Only two component is there, oxygen and neon. So total pressure is 25. Easily understand that 19.75. Or you multiply this, you get the same answer. Okay, so that's about the problems based on the Dalton's law of partial pressure. Similar problems you will do it. So now trying to discuss the ideal gases or kinetic theory of gases. Let's discuss in the next session. Okay, kinetic theory and its deviation of real gases from the ideal behavior. Thank you.